Southern Pacific SD45 even. Ah, I lost the route. Ah! Oops, brakes are off. Got your brakes on. SP9023 to dispatch. We have replaced the air hose and completed the air test and are ready to proceed. Dispatch to Southern Pacific 9023. You are cleared to proceed east under caution. I'll get back to you in just a minute. Dispatch out. I don't get it. Does that mean I'm allowed to proceed then? We've got caution, so let's do it. And we're off. PJT, what I'm going to do is I'm going to unsubscribe from the career version and resubscribe to it, so I should be able to fix it if I do that. I ran out of time for doing that tonight, so since the standard one worked, I thought I'd leave it. So that's what we're hauling, folks. We've got lots, basically a single stack mega train. Apologies for the camera flapping around. Stephen Jam, no, they're my guesstimates. So where I put DLC release scenario, it's me basically leaving a hole. It's like this week, I've filled the hole in with some scenarios for today. If one doesn't get released, then I just drop stuff in from the backlog. That's one of the nice things about the backlog. If I suddenly find I need to fill two slots, I can just go and cut and paste some stuff. Alright, thanks Phil. So just a reminder everyone, that's the last scenario. Victorian Phoenix Royale was by PJT 1974. So thanks very much, thoroughly enjoyed that. I'm going to have another go at that in the career mode at some point. Dispatch to Southern Pacific 9023. I'll have to hold you at the signal just before Tunnel 41 entrance due to a tanker train coming towards you. Shouldn't have to wait long. He's in the tunnel now and his lead unit is 8430. Dispatch out. Well, that's not my signal. Okay, fair enough. That's those two over there. Thank you. Binisev, does the GP20 on the game know when the temperature is very cold outside on startup procedure? It does, which means you have to run the thing that warms up the oil and fuel. Oil, is it? More. Before you can actually hit the start button, otherwise it just doesn't work. It also, if it's cold outside, it will also make the windows frost up, or not frost up, but mist up. It's our red light for Tunnel 41. BNSF, when you turn the cab light on, you will switch on a shadow casting light. Shadow casting lights are very expensive, and therefore that's what causes your frame rate to drop. Wait for this tanker train to come out. Here he comes. Right, that's the train in our way. There's the tankers. Jack Sims, how do you make it so passengers are really sensitive to heavy braking? So in a career scenario, you can set the score settings and then the penalties for exceeding comfort levels. That's probably how I'd do it. Good night, Dwayne DeBlaine. Frisco, I actually have no idea. I wasn't involved in it. I can't remember off the top of my head, Jack Sims. If you hover over each one, it should give you the tooltip for it. If you're not getting tooltips, go and check in settings and make sure tooltips are switched on. Right, train's out, we have the highball. Thank you. it isn't really a highball. Well, my understanding was the top green, if the top signal is green, it's a highball. Highball doesn't mean to go really fast. Highball is referring to the ball on the top. It means that you are green to go. I was watching a video recently about American trains coupling, and it was saw as before the Buckeye couplings, there was this this kind of coupling. It looks a bit like a cowbell, and if you imagine you've got these two cowbells, and then there's a bar in the middle of them, and effectively, when they're coupling up, the guy who's actually managing it with the train. He puts his hand in, effectively where these two cowbells are, he puts his hand in and lifts this thing up. And then he has to take his hand out at a right, just so that it goes into the other cowbell, and then snap his hand out so it doesn't get crushed. That's horrific. When you exit the tunnel, I have an eastbound coal drag I'm going to get you to go. I'm going to get you around. Also, you'll be crossing over to track 1 at shed 47. Dispatch out. Well, it's a busy journey. Well, no, that's the Buckeye, so that's the automatic coupler. The one I'm thinking of was a bit different. Where is it? Just trying to Google. I'm trying to drive trains and Google at the same time. This is going to end well. I realise I should be using dynamic brakes, but I need need to get off my backside and fix it so that I can use them easily on the controller. We've got the green. It was like that. The one I saw didn't look exactly like that, but the idea is the same. And that bit in the middle floated around, and so you had to actually hold it up to make sure it went into the right place. It's like, oh my word. Oh, he's up there, look. Yeah, BNSF's got it. That's the kiddies. Like, who thought that was a good idea? Honestly, who thought that was a good idea? Double yellow. We're coming back down the next bit. Yes, the other train's moving. Here it is up here. Good night, G-Force. Yes, BNSF, link and pin coupling, you're right. I just thought it was horrifying when I saw it. Okay, we're changing lines, that's why. Good night, JM1260. Thanks for joining. BNSF, why isn't the article on engine driver yet? It's waiting on some extra links to go in, back to Cytec pages. I'm just waiting to hear back from Cytec. Frisco, I haven't looked at your I don't really look at the engine driver article proposals. That's more Steve's field. Lucasone, welcome. Welcome. You got here eventually. It's snowing, so obviously we need to open the windows. Look at that drop. It's roller coaster time. Frisco, is this SP Choke? No, I did SP Choke a different day. This one is called Containers on Ice by Grahlman One. Miles to Truckee. Let's have a look at the list here. In fact, Truckee is where we're going. 9 miles. Do I play every scenario posted in the Steam chat? I play most of them. To be honest, it's not if it's posted in the Steam chat, it's whether or not it's in the Steam group. If it's posted in the Steam group, it probably gets played. Eventually. Got a green. Something wrong with the dynamic brakes on this loco, I don't seem to be doing anything. Let's just stick to using the air brakes for now. Why does Workshop have a limit on the size of routes? There is a physical or a limit that is imposed by Steam Workshop itself on the maximum size of a single workshop item, and it's based on that. Through the forest. Oops, there, this is what we need to zoom in on. Oh, the track is there. Cheers, BNSF. I'll see you tomorrow on the Dovetail stream. Frisco, the limit isn't in miles. I mean, there really isn't a... The limit is going to be way beyond anything anyone could practically make in their lifetime. The limit is in megabytes. I think it's 200 meg. Which is still a pretty enormous route, because obviously there's no assets included in that. Yeah, because you can't do assets on a workshop route. Another green. We've got an Autorack train coming up the hill to meet us. Blow the horn. I should get a screenshot of the SD45, shouldn't I, really? Where's my mouse gone? Oh, there's my mouse. Better. Damn trees. Dang trees. And I blow the horn outside the cab. I realised that wasn't a rule 14L. I don't need to do a rule 14L. I just thought I'd blow the horn in different ways. Hey, lead catcher. Cheers, thanks for joining us this evening. Good night, Escrowsnet. You're most welcome. Let me know how you get on. Miles to go. around the dogleg. Oh, you mean this bit? We're not going to the dogleg, we're just going to Truckee. Oh no, we are actually, down here, of course are we. Yes, we have gone round the dogleg. Yes, we have. Now you mention it, I remember seeing it on the map. Have to start enabling that thing in Windows where you can make the mouse get really big when you've lost it. Moggy drove on the Gemmel for the first time today. Excellent. What did you think? Where are we up to? 2.25 miles. 6 minutes left by the looks of it. Yeah, Lucasone, 315 would be very, very good for Gemmel. That's what I used to ride on all every day. Got another green here. Yep, we have the high ball. Well, we found the end of this one. Right, we're coming up on the first part of Truckee, and then we're going to take it to the other end. Not yet sold, UK. Keep forgetting, if I'm honest. Got the highball, so carry on. One and a half miles. How long left? 3 minutes. I have your relief crew standing by at Truckee Yard 3. Bring your head end down to the east yard signal at the far end. Your relief crew is standing by in the white pickup by the track. Dispatch out. Train Simmer asked a question, is Daniel Leach the recorder of the 1S model railway videos? He does some and I do some. So the official ones, which are the ones on the One Model Rail account, those are ones that I've done. But Danny posts quite a lot up to his. In fact, his ones are generally a lot more up to date because I haven't posted any in quite a long time. Right, we've got to go all the way to the other side of this siding and then we stop. How do you get snow effects, Frisco? You have to use the stock that's got snow effects. I mean, if you use the stock that comes with the route, then it will just have snow on it in the winter. Cheers, Victor. You pretty much made it. All we've got to do now is stop the train at the end of the siding. Slow down a bit too much here. Never going to get to the end of the line if we don't get moving. There's the pickup with my relief crew. Well, we've made it safely with all of our train. Let's take a well-deserved break and let the new crew continue on. Scenario complete. Whee! Right, so yes, that was Containers on Ice by Gralman1. Very good it was too. Donner Pass, SD45 Southern Pacific. Right, so yeah, that's it from me. I will see you all tomorrow, 5 p.m. on the Dovetail channel for the SD9 preview. And then we will be back here 9:30, 10, something like that. I'll let you know nearer the time, but something around that, and we'll see what we can do. Probably going to make it a short one, though, because quite often on Friday I'm really tired, and it's basically just a waste of time. So we might just make it a short one tomorrow. Well, we shall see. All right, thanks very much for watching. I shall see you all tomorrow. Take care. Bye-bye.